I was happy to be patient because I enjoyed the dialogue, and what we heard today was that there are a number of things that cannot be included in this legislation that we ought to take up, some of which are expiring on September 30, did expire on September 30, like the CHIP program. And I would put in that category the MCVE program, which was mentioned earlier, which is very important to Ohio. This is the Maternal, Infant, and Early Childhood Home Visiting Program. This is one that is working, and you know it helps provide family support through evidence-based home visiting programs. It's savings costs, it's increasing quality, and I would hope we could also reauthorize that as an example. We also heard about other legislation that's important, and I agree with what was said about the CHIMP programs. Here we are talking about CHIP, and then we're talking about CHIMP. Lots of acronyms, but basically it's changes in mandatory spending programs that is a budget gimmick. And to answer the earlier question, it's about $17 to $20 billion a year. And the Crime Victims Fund, I think, is the largest single one. And I know that Senator Cornyn has been involved with that issue as well on the Judiciary Committee. But it is something that is broken in our budgeting system, and I do support dealing with it. By the same token, I'm really glad we got a CHIP passed through the committee today. I hope we can get that through the floor. It's a vital program for Ohio. 219,000 Ohio kids are now covered through the CHIP program. And according to our Ohio folks, the Medicaid director in Ohio, Ohio is going to deplete our CHIP funding by the end of this calendar year. So it's urgent that we do move quickly and extend this funding to ensure these low-income kids continue to have access to high-quality health coverage, just as you intended, Mr. Chairman, over the years as you've worked on this. There are a couple of amendments that we had planned to offer that we're not going to offer. One, I just want to mention briefly, is the KIDS Act. And some of you have followed this closely, but about 6% of children with medically complex medical issues in this country spend about 40% of the Medicaid dollars. And there's a much more cost-effective way, and again, focusing on quality, a better way for these kids to give them the health care coverage that they need. And it's basically allowing coordination care between providers. And in Ohio, we've done this. The Cincinnati Children's Hospital has been a leader on this. We believe that we will not only be able to improve coordination and care, but again, allowing states to have this option to create these pediatric home health, these homes in Medicaid, will save the taxpayer money over time. So I would hope that we could move forward on the ACE Kids Act. I know we're still working with the committee staff, Mr. Chairman, on some concerns that they had, and we want to work through those and get that legislation passed. Senator Grassley, Senator Bennett, Senator Nelson, and I have continued to push that, and look forward to your support on that when we can come back for a different forum where we are able to move that bill forward. And then finally, there's legislation Senator Brown and I have filed called the Caring Recovery for Infant and Babies CRIB Act. CRIB is important right now because of this increased number of babies who are born with neonatal abstinence syndrome. And this is because of our opioid crisis we have in this country. And we appreciate the fact, Mr. Chairman, that your staff has worked with us on this. We hope to get the CRIB Act done as well. We're not going to offer it today, but we do think that this is very important, including being able to free up high-demand NICU beds for the treatment of newborn and babies that have other kinds of higher acuity. So we think this is actually a positive bill for the taxpayer, as well as to take better care of these babies and deal with our opioid crisis. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator.